Why in God's green earth would you want to sell something that you know is contaminated? I had one person, honest to God, told me, well, you know, Freddy, you screwed up. All you had to do was keep your mouth shut. There is no level there that's a safe level of contamination.
Fred Stone's dairy farm is contaminated with PFAS, chemicals that have been linked to serious health problems.
As the cows ingest the feed and they drink the water, it gets into the cows themselves and it translates into the milk.
The presence of these chemicals in the milk caused Stone to lose his dairy license, leaving his third-generation family business in ruins.
We don't cry over spilled milk anymore.
I really don't know how we're going to proceed out of this disaster. We should be thinking about how we're going to retire and how we're going to move on. Now we're trying to figure out how the hell we're going to stay alive. Special cow, watch
out. PFAS aren't federally regulated, and they're virtually everywhere, used for their non-stick water-resistant qualities in waterproof clothing, stain-resistant carpet, food wrappings, cookware, and even makeup. More than 98% of Americans have some amount of PFAS in their blood or tissue.
PFAS stands for per- and polyfluoroalkyl substances, so they're man-made, and they originated in around the 1930s. Studies have shown they are very acutely toxic.
PFAS are a problem, and they're a problem because they're useful chemicals so that they do something that we like, that the more we study them, the more we see adverse health impacts.
Two of the most widely studied PFAS chemicals, PFOA and PFOS, have been linked to a slew of health problems, like kidney and testicular cancers. And there's evidence that suggests PFAS can have an effect on the immune system.
PFAS compounds can interfere with the immune system and essentially prevent the production of antibodies in sufficient concentrations so that we can respond to infectious disease.
PFAS can remain in the body for many years, and scientists don't fully understand why that is. But we note that they bind to certain proteins in our bodies,
which means that they can move around, they can go from organ to organ, they can hang out in our blood, they can go to other tissues. We think that's why they stick around in our bodies. There also are some hypotheses that suggest that when PFAS get to the kidney to be excreted, the kidney doesn't get rid of them, it just transports them back into our body.
The reason PFAS don't easily degrade in our bodies or in the environment has to do with their chemistry.
So the carbon-fluorine bond is one of the strongest bonds known in chemistry. And when we make these artificially and we release them to the environment, we have to expect that those bonds are not going to degrade relatively easily at all.
When PFAS contaminate the natural resources that communities depend on, the result can be disastrous. That's what happened in Newburgh in New York, where runoff from a nearby military base containing PFOS from firefighting foam made its way into Washington Lake, contaminating the drinking water of about 30,000 people.
One of our greatest assets in the city of Newburgh has been contaminated undue to any fault of our own. It makes me angry. It makes me sad. It makes me emotional because it's not fair.
After the contamination came to light in 2016, the city changed its drinking water source and has been trying to remediate Washington Lake.
So there's 18 40,000 pound vessels of carbon. So it's granular activated carbon, 40,000 pounds per vessel.
Activated carbon treatment is a method of filtering PFAS out of water. The chemicals stick to the porous carbon as the water passes through. But removing the PFAS from the drinking water still leaves the chemicals intact.
So when you filter PFAS out of water, you're just taking it from here and putting it here, where it's either going to be incinerated or landfilled or filtered out and put somewhere else. So that's the problem with PFAS. They just get moved around. They don't get eliminated, at least with the technologies that we have right now.
Unless we do something to intervene, they'll be present for decades, if not hundreds or thousands of years to come.
My wife and I actually met showing cows together. And it was all well and good when I was beating her, but when she started beating me, that's when we had to get married, so. At least that's what I tell people. I grew up here. It means everything to my wife and I, the cows, the farm, the whole nine yards.
For more than 20 years, starting in the 1980s, the Stones fertilized their fields with nutrient-rich byproducts provided to them at first from a paper company and later from a municipal wastewater facility.
We did everything by the book, and we have the letters to prove it.
But in 2016, testing revealed a problem.
It was determined then that the contamination came from sludge spreading that we had done. We put in a water filtration system. We were trying to salvage the dairy operation to no avail. We ended up slaughtering about two-thirds of the herd. There's about 40 or so left. And these were all cow families that, again, go way back, you know, 40, 50 years. And these are cows I just can't kill. I'm sorry, I just can't kill them. We have them here. I don't know what the hell we're going to do with them.
PFAS are pervasive on the Stone farm. Elevated PFAS levels have been found in members of Stone's family, too. Stone's own blood contains PFAS levels 20 times higher than the national average.
Those cows, all they want us to do is, you know, take care of them. But I feel we failed them.